Hello, Captains. It's the Doctor. Welcome back to more Let's Play Star Trek Online with Rami Summers. This is my free-to-play character that I am playing through this game on. In the last video, I had several updates that we've made to the character in terms of getting gear in the reputation system, including this lovely new Kelvin Timeline uniform that was given to us free by Cryptic. And I have put it on, and I really, really like the looks of it. Well, I have some more gear updates to talk about in this video since the last one. I've been doing some more grinding as well. But before we get to that, just something I wanted to show you guys and talk about here in the clothing. Maybe this has been fixed now. But I had noted in the last video that I was missing the stripes here near the hands, and it looked like that the rank wasn't showing up correctly. And everything. So, wanted to look at that again because I did select the rank of general, you see. I did select that rank here. So if you do like, let's back up a bit. If you do like ensign, See, it doesn't do anything in terms of rank until you get to Brigadier General. For some reason, it's showing what? Aren't these Klingon? Aren't these Klingon designations, or are these Federation designations? But at Brigadier General here, it starts to show this yellow color up here, or orangish yellow color for the markings. Nothing down here. And then when you go Admiral, it looks like this, which I think is it's got to be a bug. Maybe the coloring's off. Okay, there we go. I guess we can change the coloring of it there. I wish they would have the actual... Oh, there we go. Maybe something like that. That looks a little bit closer to what it's supposed to look like, maybe. If you go to Major General, however, look at that. See, they go away on the arms. And then you've got this little golden stripe here. And I guess that's my skin clipping through this, which is terrible. They need to fix that. But then when you go to general, which would be max rank, I have nothing. Nothing on the sleeves and nothing up here. Just all silver now. So I don't know if this is a bug or, you know, a problem with the uniform they need to fix. But it seems to me that the graphics for the rankings are off a bit, and maybe even the titles themselves. I think I like the look of Admiral, so I'm gonna keep like the Admiral look. I'm gonna keep like this look here. It ain't perfect, but let's make that a little more silver instead of black. It ain't perfect, but it's better. I wish I could make these pips up here, you see, yellow, but apparently I can't. But at least I've got the stripes around the hands. I still don't think it looks right, though. I think they need to fix some problems here. We'll just go ahead and save that outfit anyway, but I think they definitely have some visual problems with this thing they need to fix. Let me know what you guys think about that, because I'm not exactly sure how it's supposed to look. It's showing. I can barely see it in this lighting. Okay, well, let's talk about the next thing. So remember how I talked about I needed to get some more Iconian marks in order to get the impulse engine? Well, I did it, folks. I went ahead and grinded, all those marks I needed for the Iconian marks to get that impulse engine. So now I do have the Iconian Resistance Hyper Impulse Engine Mark 12. This has a plus 5% defense, plus 18 flight speed, which by the way is higher than my Solanae engine I had on before. This has a plus 19.2 flight turn rate, plus 5 engine power setting, and when at 100% throttle, a plus 8.8 energy damage resistance rating, and all power to engines as well. But the big part here is that it is part of the Iconian set, which has the two-piece bonus called Enhanced Shield Distribution. So by having this plus a deflector, I now have this ability that's a passive ability that's just automatically enabled. It says distribute shields applies 163.1 shield regeneration for 5 seconds to each facing. Once triggered, goes on 30-second cooldown. So that's automatic. I don't have to do anything for that. It just is automatically an extra little healing ability there for me. But now I got the Iconian Deflector and Iconian Impulse. So I'm only two pieces away. I need the Warp Core and the Shield to get the whole four-piece bonus set out of the space set. And so that's what I'm working my way towards. As you will see, I am on Tier 3, and I am working on Tier 4 of the Reputation, but now I'm totally out of marks, because buying that Impulse Engine cost 750 marks. So yeah, I was able to get enough marks to buy it, but then after buying it, it just wiped me out on marks. Now I have no more marks left. So I'm going to have to do some more grinding to get enough marks to unlock the continuing levels here, the continuing tiers. Once I unlock those tiers, then I'll have access to the Warp Core and the Shield. So that's going on. I also have almost completed the entire Delta Alliance Reputation. You will see that after this next one that runs out here in 19 hours, almost 20 hours, that should unlock Tier 5 of the Delta Alliance. I should now have Tier 5 unlocked, and that'll give me access to the armor piece I need on the ground. And that's going to cost a lot of marks too, but once you hit Tier 5, you get a whole bunch of mark rewards in that tier, so it'll give me enough marks that I need to buy that final piece to my ground set. So one more day, and I'll have the Delta Alliance set completely done that I want for the ground. So that's going to be real nice. I look forward to that. That means all our missions continuing after this mission today, all our missions after this one, should all be done now with the total Delta Alliance ground set. So I'm looking forward to that. That's going to help us a lot there on those ground missions. And then on the space, of course, I'll just keep working on the Iconian set, you know, as I continue to do that. But at least I got two of the pieces now. I didn't think I would have two of the pieces by this point in time. I thought it would take me a lot longer to get there, but I was able to do it. Apparently, a lot of people like to pug the elite version of Brotherhood of the Sword, which I'm very happy about, because the elite version gives you the most amount of marks for any type of, you know, hardness level. The elite version gives you the most, and you get those... I get these ones here, these Krylon gas, these rare Krylon gases, which sell really good in the exchange, so I can build up my energy credits quite a bit too by playing these. So it's a win-win situation there, really nice. Also, Gateway to Grethor seems to be a pug that people are also playing on Advanced, and they actually do quite well. I'm surprised. I haven't had a failed Gateway to Grethor yet pugging it, so... that's quite nice, actually. I'm able to get some good marks playing those things. And then, of course, I still get Iconian marks from doing the Kobali runs on Kobali Prime. I do those last two missions, so you can get the data probes and you get the marks. I've got 30 data. I've got more data probes than I ever will need, but I just need more marks now, just low on marks. Okay, let's do the next mission here. Under the Iconian War, we have... Time in a Bottle. Voyager, under the command of Admiral Tuvok, has been chasing leads regarding a Delta Quadrant race known as the Krynim. So far, he has only been able to turn up rumors and a bunch of anomalous sensor readings. But now, we found a Ferengi selling what he claims are Krynim artifacts. You are authorized to negotiate with the Ferengi and obtain these artifacts and follow the trail it provides to where it leads.
We have a lead on the Krynim. Voyager went to Krynim space looking for them a few months ago, but didn't find much more than a Vardwa and some anomalous sensor readings. But now, we found a Ferengi selling what he claims are Krynim artifacts. You are authorized to negotiate with the Ferengi and obtain these artifacts. Follow the trail where it leads. We need a weapon against the Iconians, and the Vardwa have gone to a great deal of trouble to keep whatever secrets the Krynim have out of our hands.
Go to Drozana Station. We'll get a special duty officer, Somog, an emote, Ferengi Dance, and several options here, which means I'm going to have to replay this mission because there's several good things here I want to get. A Chronoton Jolt, the Split Beam Rifle Chronoton, the Temporal Flux Generator, there's some good things here, so I definitely will be replaying this mission a bit. Let's just transwarp straight there so we don't waste any time. Make primary time in a bottle. Now that I'm able to generate some good energy credits, I can waste a few to get there. So our ship is slowly progressing to an Iconian build here, which is quite nice.
Welcome to Josanna. You're cleared for docking. We have everything you need for shore leave, and a few things that you didn't even know you wanted. Shopping, drinking, dining, entertainment. You'll find it all here. And don't forget the 77th rule of acquisition. If you break it, I'll charge you for it.
Just like a Ferengi. Okay, we need to go here. Time in a bottle. Here we go. Sir, business facilitator Quinn has rented space at this station for his private sales meetings. We aren't sure what the object he is selling is yet, but the rumors are that it's a technological device of some sort. The price Quinn is asking for is quite significant. You could buy a moon for this much latinum. Starfleet Command reports that additional assistance is en route, but that we should go ahead and make an attempt to obtain the device. Why, hello there, receptionist.
May I help you? Oh. Wait, you must be. I'm sorry, but the business facilitator is busy at the moment and cannot be disturbed.
We had an appointment, actually.
Yes, but Quinn left me explicit instructions about this. He's in the middle of a delicate negotiation to triple his profits on the sale of a rare Delta Quadrant artifact, and cannot be disturbed.
Well, doesn't Quinn want to hear an offer from the combined financial resources of Starfleet, the Klingon Empire, and the Romulan Republic?
Maybe. Let's see. It was something. Krenim, I think? Oh, Delta Quadrant treasures are all the rage right now. Artifacts from cultures the Vatwar wiped out are particularly valuable. Quinn's made quite a bit of latinum bringing them back through the gateways. Now, that profit-sharing plan he promised me hasn't materialized, but is it my place to complain?
I know you're just doing your job, but it's very important we get that artifact, please.
I'm sorry, but my instructions were very clear.
There must be something we can do for you in exchange.
Well, I'm sorry, but I need this job. I'm trying to save up enough for a ticket off this station.
I will arrange for transportation for you to anywhere you'd like to go, free of charge. Wow.
Okay. You can? What am I saying? You have a starship, of course you can. Go on ahead. Quinn and the other buyer are in the cargo bay, but you better hurry. They were trying to get the deal finalized before you could stop them. Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right, my crew will make arrangements for you. Cool. There, see, I helped her out. I didn't want to threaten her. No point to threaten her. Let's help her out. We're Starfleet. We got her off this station and made her happy. Now let's talk to Quinn. There we go.
Not so fast! The gentleman with the rather imposing associates over there has just made a very competitive offer for the device. Care to make a counterbid?
I'll make it worth your time to deal exclusively with me.
You said there weren't any other buyers, Quinn! Now what do I see? Starfleet stooges here to cause trouble! Guards, get these riffraff out of here so I can conclude my deal in peace!
I'm not leaving without the device. Oh, we're going to battle.
Enemy targets on sensors. Personal shield losing power.
Well, that was easy. That didn't take long at all. Okay, now do you want to talk? Oh, guess not. Okay, there we go. Let me go grab this thingy here. Now do you want to talk?
Fine! I'll add what I was going to pay those guards to my off.
Hold it!
Ah, Nog.
I am Nog, son of Grand Nagus Rom. And I am a Ferengi. And when you deal with these people, you deal with me. You have a choice. Either deal with me, or I ask my father to have a word with the liquidators about your poor business practices.
Well, I'm sure we can come to an understanding.
That's what I thought. Now, kiss the staff.
Kiss the staff.
Get out.
Get out.
Not you, Quinn.
Nog ordering everybody around.
Here's my best offer. How about we agree on a price, and you get your Delta Quadrant doodad, and I leave. Everyone's happy.
Not so fast, Quinn.
No? Fine. How about I answer your questions, and maybe then I get to leave? But let's get on with it. Every minute I stand here, I'm losing a strip of latinum. Time is a very valuable commodity.
What do you know about the relic?
The device is Krenim in origin. Specifically, it's from the Krenim Imperium. Constructed sometime in the mid-22nd century, if I had to take a guess. Strange piece of technology. I haven't seen anything else like it. Highly advanced, and it has hallmarks of Krenim work. But it's, odd. Definitely odd.
What happened to the Krenim?
The Vodvar, that's what! At one point, the Krenim Imperium held more than 200 star systems in the Delta Quadrant. They lost some of that territory in a couple wars, but overall they were doing well. Not the biggest business in the Quadrant, but not the smallest either. When the Vardvar started their war, Gaul took a special interest in the Krenim. Bombed them back to the Stone Age, and then some. As far as anyone knows, the Krenim are basically extinct these days.
Where did you get the device?
I picked it up from a Talaxian who wanted to trade for supplies. He told me he got it from the Kayana system. That was it. There used to be a Krenim colony there, but it's gone now, just like the rest of their empire.
Gone? The Vodvar destroyed him?
The Talaxian wasn't very clear on that. He just said, gone. If I'd asked any more questions, he might have increased his price.
Anything else?
As a show of good faith to the son of the Nagus, I'm willing to tell you for free. But don't let this get around. It would ruin my reputation as a businessman. The device emits some unusual energy readings. The shielding may have malfunctioned, or maybe it's not fully operational anymore. I'm not sure. But that's why I'm selling it as an antique. As is, and no refunds.
What kind of unusual energy readings?
Do I look like a member of the Vulcan Science Academy to you? I don't know. It's yours now. You paid for it. You figure it out. I hope it doesn't blow up your ship. Now, may I go so we can put all this unpleasantness behind us? I want to drown my sorrows in a comet cocktail and think about all the profit I didn't earn today.
Go and stay out of trouble. All right. How'd you do that? How'd I do what?
Don't let the staff of Avis and these good looks fool you. I'm here as a Starfleet officer, and I don't normally flaunt my family connections, but in this case, it seemed like the best way to solve the problem. So I borrowed my dad's second best staff.
Ah. Well, thanks for the assist. It didn't look like Agua was going to let us purchase this Krenim artifact while he was still in the room.
Interesting. I know Voyager encountered the Krenim during the journey, and Tuvok was looking for survivors of the Vodvar purges. For now, though, perhaps we should concentrate on learning what we can from this device.
Agreed. Now, what should we do about the force field?
Quinn left without taking down his security, but fortunately I know how to get around it. This isn't a very sophisticated system. It's hardly worth the latinum he paid for it. If we overload the EPS conduits, we'll create a cascade failure in the system that the control protocols won't be able to handle. That should drop the force field.
Alright, just overload the EPS conduits. That was really,
You can overload the EPS conduits in the corner there.
Let's do that.
Now that the power flow is disrupted, we can override the administrative access requirement. The controls are... Yes! Over here by the artifact. Excellent. Now we can get a good look at this. The waveforms aren't like anything I've seen before. I think I'm getting something. This is definitely Krenim in origin. And Quinn was right on the age. I'm also seeing some repeating elements in the base code, almost like a signature. And that strange energy Quinn was talking about is actually chronotons. A lot of chronotons. And chronotons mean temporal manipulation. This little box just got a lot more interesting.
Oh, great. I hate temporal mechanics.
I'll take the device back to my ship, the Chimera, and have a look while we're on the way to the Kiana system. From what I understand, Voyager sent an away team to the Kiana system a few weeks ago, but they encountered some resistance and were forced to pull back before they can find what they were looking for. But now that we have this, maybe we'll be able to find what remains of the Krenim, if there's anything left to find.
All right, see you in the Delta Quadrant. So a strange Krenim device with chronoton properties.
I've explored many places as a Starfleet officer, but this is my first time seeing the Delta Quadrant.
Well,
according to Quinn, the Krenim artifact came from this system. I hope we haven't come all this way just to chase ghosts. I've had a chance to look at the Krenim device, although I'm not sure how to activate it yet. It's definitely designed for temporal manipulation, although I don't think it would enable someone to travel through time. It's almost like a step sideways, if that makes any sense at all. I'll keep working on it and let you know if I learn anything more.
Perhaps we can find something here that can explain it.
Voyager's preliminary scans of the system turned up a number of anomalies, but nothing conclusive. According to Krenim records, though, there's supposed to be an M-class planet in this system. We're not reading anything like that on the sensors.
Maybe the planet is the source of the asteroids. We're also picking up some wreckage.
Could be. Let's check that wreckage out first. It might give us a better idea of what happened out here. And we should be on the lookout for Vodwar. Preliminary scans indicate they've been actively patrolling through this system.
Let's...
Keep an eye out for Vodwar. They're still patrolling this area.
Well, let's take a look then. Here's some wreckage.
If I had to place a bet, I'd say that wreckage is where this artifact was found. Heads up! Vodwar on an intercept course.
Target shield has failed. Right shield's failing.
Vodwar are no problem for me.
The wreckage appears to be Krenim. The weapon signatures are definitely Vodwar. According to Voyager, the Krenim were a fairly small society. There had to be a reason the Vodwar went out of their way to target them. Let's move. There might be more ships in range. There are more Vodwar on an intercept course, but we may be able to avoid them. I suggest we use the mineral content of the asteroids I've marked to conceal our energy signatures. Vodwar sensors aren't as good as ours. Most of their technological advantage appears to be directed toward making better weapons. So it should work, as long as we don't attract their attention before we get out of their path.
Okay, let's use the asteroid as cover. This mission is very wordy, by the way. That's one thing I wanted to say. Very wordy. A lot of dialogue in it.
Herald! They must be looking for that Vardwar patrol. I don't think those heralds detected us. Let's hope they don't come back this way.
Okay. Take scans of the moon, it says. Now that I've made all these upgrades to our ship, especially with the reputation gear, the Iconian stuff, and other stuff I've made, I mean, it's really, really, really helping. I can tell a difference.
Herald's inbound!
I watch these heralds
Fosmar
here.
Fosmar must have gotten a signal out.
Watch how good I can take these things out now.
So much for our investigation.
Target shield have failed.
Pretty cool, huh? I have been playing a,
There was something about the Krenim that was such a threat to the Vodwar and the Iconians that they're still patrolling the old Krenim systems. If we can find more Krenim technology, or maybe unlock what we have, we might be able to find out what is so important. That could be something the Alliance can use against the Iconians. I recommend that the Chimera and your ship patrol the outer system while we take an away team to the surface. I'll bring the device and keep trying to learn more about it.
I was going to say, I have been playing a lot of those STFs now with the heralds. Gateway to Grethor, where you have to fight the herald ships. And then, of course, on the ground, Brotherhood of the Sword. I've been doing a lot of that now. And now all these little upgrades I keep making to the ship just keeps improving it more and more. And I'm finding it easier and easier now to fight in these, you know, in-game STFs with this ship now. You know, at first it was a little underpowered, I would say, and I still think, obviously, my weapon loadout itself is, you know, not the right modifiers and not very good quality and all that stuff. Definitely will need to improve the weapons themselves, but, you know, just everything else that I've been doing around the weapons that I can with reputation gear or, you know, more specialization points to open up more specialization traits or other traits that I've been changing around and adding and stuff. For example, now I've got the best defense from the last mission on here. Just little things like that that I keep upgrading have really helped to make this ship quite enjoyable in combat now. It's still an escort. It still, you know, suffers a lot of hull damage, but I've negated some of that. And I'm doing a lot more damage now than I was before, so it's really fun. Anyway, just wanted to put that out there. Let's go down to the ground.
This doesn't make sense. There's nothing here that would cause the readings I was seeing from orbit, but there are traces of chronotron particles. I've never known chronotrons to appear naturally without some sort of temporal manipulation going on, but there's nothing here. I'm starting to come up with a theory, but I need some more data. I recommend we take some additional scans.
Okay.
Exactly. But we need to be quick. Those patrols we encountered in orbit will be missed soon. I'm going to order the Chimera to try to avoid contact, but warn us if more ships arrive.
Okay.
These tall spires are charged with temporal energy. Curious. It's almost like it's in a state of temporal flux.
Most curious.
I need to get some scans. There's something going on. There are more mineral deposits over there. There's a resonant frequency here that's not natural.
You don't say.
I'm reading another anomaly ahead.
Yay, I win.
These anomalies have a shape, like a warp field, but not quite the same.
Really strange. A warp field on a planet?
The only other place I've seen sensor readings like this was in the wormhole.
Captain, heralds have landed and are approaching your position. Fall back. We'll deal with the heralds already here.
There! Behind those rocks!
Time for some herald action. I want to set
up. Hurry! They'll be here any moment.
I want my engineer to set up some turrets. There we go.
This area looks defensible. Get ready. I have an idea. We need to use the device. I've been trying to activate it, and I've almost got it. Keep them busy. If I can get it working, I should be able to conceal us.
Work quickly. Because we got company. Or we will have company.
Here they come!
Oh dang, I'm dead. Oh, I had a thrall on me that whole time. I didn't even see him. Didn't even see him. Dang, everybody's dead. Heralds are definitely tougher than the Vodwar.
Enemy targets on center. Flanking damage detected.
Ow. Okay, we're all dead. Well, that's just great. Carrie, save us! Oh, she's dead too. Wow, that was pretty rough right there. Nog, I hope you can defend yourself.
Personal shield losing power.
Watch out! There's more of them! I need more time to align these frequencies! Almost there. Just one more connection and that should...
Nog, you're gone. You disappeared. No, we need you. Defeat the final wave. Okay, that got him. Fall back! Get to defensive position on ridge. Hurry! We have to move up to the ridge. I'm hurrying. Oh, they're right here. I love this gravity ability here. Kind of pulls them together and does kinetic damage, I think. What's it called? Gravity spike? Graviton spike? Yeah, it like pulls them together and then does like kinetic damage. Knock towards center. Knocks them towards the center and then does kinetic damage. I really like that ability. Would you die already, please? Jeez, come on, guys. Like, shoot the guy. See, when I do it here, it draws others near him together, but there was nobody near him. And then does kinetic damage. Why am I shooting at the ground? Here they come. Let's call in reinforcements.
Flanking damage detected. Personal shield losing power.
What? Captain Nog?
If you'll forgive the pun, I managed to buy us some time.
Well, that would be useful. Thank you. Cool. We're like in another dimension or temporal phase.
It's taken me some time to convince the Krenim to help us, but they finally agreed. Remember how I said the device could remove someone from the time stream? It did. That's where we are now, in the temporal bubbles. And how we perceive time in here is a little different than outside. That's why the Heralds can't see us. We're out of their timelines. Out of all timelines, in fact. While we're here, it's almost like we don't exist.
And not existing is an improvement?
No one's shooting at us. I think that's a good thing. The Krenim are... they're a little touchy. Almost being driven to extinction by the Vaudoir has made them suspicious. But they're willing to talk to us if we help them stabilize the temporal energy. I suggest we help. I wouldn't want to be in here if the fields collapse.
Okay, let's talk to the Krenim leader. Hello there.
I've had some time to observe you and Captain Nog, and your actions make it clear that you are no friend of the Vaudoir or the Heralds. This does not, however, assure me that you will be allies to my people. The Krenim have lost much. Our empire is gone, and our people have been killed or scattered. We are what remains. And I will do whatever I must to protect this system, even if it means leaving you to face the Heralds alone.
What can we do to prove ourselves?
You have already repaired some of our emitters that were damaged by the attack, but there is more yet to do. Should our temporal equipment fail, this location will be instantly overrun by Heralds. If that happens, none of us will survive.
How can we assist you?
More of our emitters must be realigned, and there are other pieces of equipment my people are already working to repair. Assist my team, and then we will talk again.
Help the Krenim repair the temporal technology, keeping them safe from the Heralds. Okay, let's help them out, and maybe they'll help us. Sounds like a fair trade. And while we're here, the Heralds can't see us.
Your fight overloaded some of the power couplings we used to moderate the temporal flow. If we had a contained space like the technology was originally designed for, this wouldn't be a problem. But we keep pushing the boundaries of what these flow modulators will do. I'm rerouting the power to take stress off the damaged couplings. But first, we need to get this capacitor aligned and ready for the transfer.
Well, let's align the capacitor then.
Okay, now it's starting to look like something.
Did I help? I guess I did that one. Okay, yeah, I helped. I did a thing, yay. Let's do more things, I guess. Let's do this one over here.
The temporal compensators are out of alignment. They help keep us at a stable point in the timeline. If they fail completely, we could end up lost in time. Grab a hyperspanner. We need to get this fixed before the drift coefficient moves out of the safe zone.
Okay. Fix the emitter. Begin repairs. I don't know what to do first.
You should realign the matrix crystals.
So let's realign the matrix crystals. Next.
You need to disconnect the buffer before you do anything else.
Disconnect buffer. Got it. Next, I guess the only thing that's left is reconnect the buffer.
Good. I'll put the next location on your tricorder.
Oh, good. Okay, we helped. We did a thing. I don't know what we did, but we did a thing. We realigned a thing to do a thing that did a thing, and the thing is done. Now on to another thing. That's kind of creepy. Keep popping up just right in front of you.
Hold this. No, hold it right next to the bracket. Or the spanner won't... There. Got it. Thanks. Something is putting too much stress on these components. I'm not sure what it is, but we don't have enough spare parts to keep rebuilding this transceiver. Grab a tricorder and run a level 3 diagnostic. Maybe there are some microfractures. If we can find and repair those, this should hold out until I can fabricate a new unit.
Can I ask you about this technology? Why are you having so many problems with it?
Anorax's original designs are for a temporal field that's big enough for a ship. Sizable, but finite. We've adapted the tech to cover much larger areas, but that makes the field more unstable, and we had to get everything operational before the Vadwar found us. So we cut some corners. A lot of corners. We're making updates and repairs as fast as we can, but we can't afford a failure. This tech is the only thing keeping us alive. Hold this.
Got it. Alright, fix this thing. Something is putting too much stress, maybe microfractures. If those are repaired, it should hold out until a new unit can be fabricated.
You need to scan for microfractures.
Okay, scan for microfractures.
You'll need to formulate an epoxy.
Okay, formulate an epoxy and then repair microfractures.
That should do it.
Hey, okay, we did it. Speak with the Krenim leader now.
You've shown you're willing to help. Now perhaps we can come to a mutually beneficial arrangement.
How?
We have Anorax's plans, but not the... Interesting. The Heralds are opening a gateway.
What?
The repairs should be enough.
I beg mercy, Great One. It appears they used a cloaking device and escaped.
You are forgiven. Make preparations to depart.
As you command.
By your command.
An interesting development.
These sentients have proven to be resourceful. Already they have thwarted our plan to bring in the Solanae fleet.
Worms! Their struggles are meaningless!
And yet they injured even you, Tiket. I advise caution. They are more dangerous than they appear.
We should bring their worlds asunder. Spill them with blood until it fills the oceans. It is time to strike.
I understand you want vengeance, but we must not act in haste.
We will continue with our plan. The whole must be as one. The attack on Iconia broke our unity. We were divided, diminished, weak. The other saved us from oblivion, but it took centuries to rebuild our bonds. We cannot risk more loss. The whole must be as one. The campaign will continue as planned.
And they didn't even see us that whole time.
They couldn't see us? There were Iconians right in front of us and nothing! They had no idea we were here. We were completely safe.
You're right. This could be what we need.
The only protection left to my people is our ability to manipulate time. But it is something we must do with great care. Even the most innocuous of changes can ripple through reality in unexpected ways.
You're talking about advanced temporal theory.
My people and I have made Anorax's theories of temporal manipulation our lives' work. In at least one temporal variant, his ship made the Krenim Imperium the undisputed masters of this region of space. If only we could recreate that vessel.
What vessel?
Anorax designed a ship, a wondrous vessel, that could manipulate the time streams and erase elements in an attempt to bring about a desired result. Our records show that he even attempted to use this vessel to restore the Krenim's fortunes. But he was defeated by an unknown alliance. Afterward, the Krenim Imperium declined, as perhaps was its fate all along. We were diminished, but content to let time progress as it would. Until the Vardwar.
About that unknown alliance, I might have an idea who that was. You might not like the answer, though. Okay, the Vardwar destroyed all the Krenim colonies in this area.
The first Krenim worlds to fall managed to warn the others. When the Vardwar came, we hid ourselves in the time stream. It was the only way we survived. Before the Vardwar arrived, we were working on a relic. It was a replica of Anorax's time ship. With it, we could have gone back and eliminated the Vardwar threat before it even began. The Vardwar's assault on the Imperium took too much from us. Now we possess Anorax's work, but not the means to bring it to life. You have seen what our technology can do. We have the designs. You have the manpower and the materials. Perhaps your governments would be interested in mutual cooperation. Allow us a chance to undo what the Vardwar did. And we will give you something that will erase your enemies from time itself.
A generous offer, but it is one we would need to consider carefully. Do you want to risk all you have left on a chance for success?
There's more here than what you've seen.
You've hidden the entire planet?
Yes. We removed ourselves from the time stream to stay alive. With your help, we can change everything.
You hid an entire planet, but you can't build this time ship on your own?
We have the plans. Our resources are almost gone.
We have shipyards, workers, and all the materials you could need.
Precisely. We revealed ourselves to you as a gesture of good faith. What will you do in return?
We need to take this back to the Alliance.
The Iconians and the Heralds are gone. It's safe to resync with our time and contact our ship. But this is huge! A whole Krenim colony that survived the Vardwar? One that has temporal technology that even the Iconians can't counter? A weaponized timeship that can erase entire civilizations like they never existed? This could change the entire war! We could have a chance now!
Yeah, well... Sir, is that what happened? We've been scanning for you, but you just disappeared. We've been hiding in the debris to stay away from the Herald ships, and then, you're not going to believe this, there is a planet here now, an entire planet. Did you find something down there, something that could conceal an entire planet? Yeah, we found the Krenim. I'll explain soon. Wow. This mission actually revealed a whole lot of information. Let's turn this in, and we'll talk about it.
Temporal mechanics is not a complication we need, but this weapon they are proposing sounds intriguing. You and Captain Nog were correct in thinking the Alliance would be interested in investigating such a thing. Personally, I approve of anything the Iconians might fear. Kapla!
Now, we're going to get this Somog Special Duty Officer, we're going to get the Ferengi Dance, we're going to get the Dilithium Ore, but now we have a chance of a chance to select some options here for items. Chronoton Split Beam Rifle, a Chronoton Jolt. I'm not sure what that does. I'm reading it now. Run Speed. We'll try that out. We've got Temporal Flux Generator, gain immunity to all damage. Reusing, oh yeah, okay, I remember what that is now. Okay, cool. So there are some good things here. I'm going to select the Chronoton Split Beam Rifle, and I'm going to have to replay the mission, but I'm going to get both of these items. I'm going to get the Chronoton Jolt and the Flux Generator, because I definitely want both of those items. I might go ahead and replay it for the shield as well, because I do need a better shield on my bridge officers, and this is an interesting shield here. Tetrion Phaser Polaron Resistance. Anyway, let's go for the split beam rifle now, and I'll replay this for the other pieces. Okay, so this mission was actually a lot of fun, and now if you've ever watched the series Star Trek Voyager, then you will recognize the Krenim, you will recognize Anorax, you will recognize the ship, you will recognize the Year of Hell, you will recognize the Alliance that went up against the Anorax there with Voyager, the temporal shielding they created. All of that will be familiar to you, and this mission here will make a whole lot more sense. If you've never seen Star Trek Voyager and you've never seen the Year of Hell Part 1 and 2, then this is going to be, well, just out of the blue. It's going to be totally out of the blue for you. You're not going to know who Anorax was or this ship or anything like that. So it just depends from where you're coming from. If you already know about this stuff, then this is a cool throwback to that episode of Star Trek, and it's a continuation of the Krenim and what has happened to them since then. Because after Janeway restored everything and made things back to normal, the Krenim were just a regular mundane race, not very special out there. They may have had these theories from Anorax, but they didn't have the application of it. Or so, actually, by this point, they do have some application of it, but they have not recreated Anorax's ship yet. So they are powerful in the sense that they have these temporal manipulation theories, but they didn't have the actual ship to make it happen. But they're still... The Iconians are still scared of them, in a way, or wanted the Vodwar to wipe them out, because they could have potentially created the technology to wipe the Iconians away. And that's what the Iconians were afraid of, and so hence the Vodwar. They ordered the Vodwar, you know, to take out the Krenim, and here we are today. So, but if you don't know about any of that, then this is just a new alien race for you. So what you should know about the Krenim is, way back in the 22nd century, a person named Anorax created this theory that he could change the timeline, or change time, not by time traveling, but by erasing something from time itself, thus changing the course of history. So for example, let's say you erased the moon around our planet a long time ago. That would irrevocably change Earth. You know, if the moon never existed in all of time, then the outcome of Earth and whatever happened on Earth and all that would be forever changed. Who knows what would happen? Things would be different. Things would be a lot different. Or let's say this is a more interesting way of using the technology, but let's say there's an asteroid out there, you know, in space, and you remove that asteroid from history, you delete it from history, just think of how many things that could impact. Because in the course of time, millions, billions, trillions of years, whatever, that asteroid could have affected so many different things. I mean, gravity itself, you know, affecting upon the asteroid to other bodies in space, affecting other things. Just the deletion of that one body in space could change millions of planets in weird ways that you would never think possible. So it's things like that that his theory was about. And in that technology, part of the technology was not just removing something from history, but creating the technology to actually step outside of time itself, like they were here, so that when you made those changes to history, you would not be part of that history. You would be outside of time, so that you could experience what the differences are. Because, like, if you were in the same time stream and you changed something, everything, including your own mind, your own history that you knew, would change with you. You would not know anything's changed. The only way you would know that something is different or changed is to be outside of the timeline, so you could witness it from, like, a third-party perspective. So he created, like, those technologies. Now, in one timeline, he created the Anorax, which is a ship that actually did that, and for like 200 years went around trying to bring his wife back to life by destroying certain things in time, wiping out whole civilizations, trying to set things the way he thought they should be set. And that, of course, changed everything in the Delta Quadrant and Voyager, because it was locally around in local space at the time when all this was happening. So everything got changed on Voyager, too. We went all of a sudden from everything was, just great here in the Delta Quadrant to all of a sudden the Voyager has been fighting these powerful, like, Krennim all of a sudden for, like, a year and is, like, falling apart. It was a really good episode, or two-part episode. It was really, really good. And then it ends up happening that the Voyager creates this temporal shielding that protects them against changes in, well, I guess whatever weapon, the chronoton weapons that the Anorax was using. And because of that, they experienced one of these time changes. All of time changed around them, and they were able to finally see it happening and realizing that time has changed, and now they finally see what's going on, that he's changing history, he's changing time. And so then they create this alliance with the local ships around there. The Zol, I think, is one of them, and some others, and they take out the Anorax. That's the gist of it. It's a really good two-parter. I recommend it. But this mission here, this is after Janeway had fixed that timeline and brought things back around to how they were at the beginning. She basically reset everything. It was a big reset at the end. And so she reset everything, and so here we are now. But the Krennim, they don't have the Anorax, but they still have those technologies that he was building in the 22nd century. He was, you know, working on those theories, and they've been working on that problem ever since. They just hadn't actually built the Anorax. But anyway, that's all good, and this mission here just really expands upon that, and I really like that. I mean, that was a good thing to do. Bringing the Krennim into this, and it's going to turn out, actually, the Krennim are a huge part in the Sphere Builders and the Temporal Cold War. This mission is the start of a path that this game is going down to explain a lot of stuff about the Temporal Cold War and the Sphere Builders. And this right here, this mission is the start of it, with what we've discovered about the Krennim here. And as this develops through the Iconian War, you're going to see how the Krennim play a huge part in, well, everything from here on out. From now through Future Proof to the current, you know, missions, the Temporal Cold War, all of it. The Krennim play a huge part. So anyway, that's cool. I like the mission rewards for this as well. I very, very much specifically like this Chronoton split beam rifle. I used it quite a bit when I first played this mission when it very first came out. Now what I want to do is I have been using this Herald anti-proton split beam projector for a very long time, and it's been a very, very good weapon for us, and it's doing a lot of DPS, over 200 DPS on ground. And what I want to do is I want to upgrade the Chronoton to Mark 14, and I want to start using it and try it out and see, because I did like it a lot. I wish I could get the low-buy version of the anti-proton projector, because there's a low-buy version of this Herald weapon that's even better than this. Unfortunately, you have to have keys to open boxes to get low-buy crystals, and it's like 200 or 250 low-buys to buy that weapon, so I can't do that right now. But I do want to try out some other weapons, because I've been like solely using this weapon forever in the game, and it's good, and it's given me a lot of DPS. But I do notice sometimes when I click the buttons to activate it in my hotbar, there's a lot of lag sometimes using it between actually activating the button and it firing. And I want to see if a different weapon will behave a little differently with that. So I actually want to give this Chronoton split beam some use. And I think it might be good against the Heralds anyway, because it uses Chronoton, Chronoton radiation. And that's devastating to the Heralds and the Iconians. So I want to try this Chronoton beam rifle out for a while. So I think I'm going to upgrade it to Mark 14, and then I'm going to replace it with the Herald anti-proton split beam, and we'll compare the DPS in the next mission. I'll do that, and we'll compare the DPS between the two and see which one is actually better on DPS end of things. But then I want to try it out anyway in a mission and see how it works and all that stuff, because I did quite like it. Let's get our special bridge officer. We've got Somog. He's a Ferengi. He's ground. Grant gold-pressed latinum on defeating nearby enemies. So that's cool. He's a traitor. So we got a new duty officer there. So that's good. And yeah, like I said, I am going to replay this mission several times to get the rest of the rewards that this mission offers. And then otherwise, we will get to the next mission. After that, we will do Broken Circle. We only have three more left here in the Iconian War. We got Broken Circle, Butterfly, and then Midnight. So there's only three left here in the Iconian War. All right, everybody. Well, thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next one.